How's it going, guys? Welcome back to another edition of Gunsmoke. And I know it's been quite a few weeks since the last episode, but things have been quite hectic over the last month. I was in London to see some of the tennis at Wimbledon, and then my brother was over for his far theatre. He was down from the north, so it's been kind of a lot going on. But yeah, thankfully back to watching another episode because it is a show I've been really enjoying. So yeah, with that, let's watch episode 11 of Gunsmoke.
Boot hills just arise on the Kansas flatlands. A few tufts of buffalo grass, some weathered markers, and the soapweed blowing in the wind. But over there in Dodge, they don't think about how ugly it is, or the useless killing that puts men here.
Part of the responsibility of being the marshal.
Use their gun belts and go on the prod. Yet more often than not, they end up here on Boot Hill. Your name, Nash?
That's right.
How are you doing in Dodge?
Do you know
I got business.
When I see a man like you going into a bank, I want to know why.
Mr. Nash works here.
Ah.
You're the new banker?
That's right. I'm Drew Holt. I'm glad to know you, Marshal.
You know what kind of a man you've hired here?
I can assure you his business with me is legitimate. I'm sure he won't cause you any trouble.
I give you my word. He's had some run-ins in the past, maybe, or he has a reputation.
All right.
That goes before him. Saucy little opener there. Setting the stage.
I noticed a sign down the street. New bank.
Oh, yeah. It opened just after you left.
Deliberate? Wait till he was gone before establishing it, like maybe getting some things done while he was away.
The good citizens of your town a great deal.
Oh?
Yes, I rode in last week with a remount party to Fort Dodge, General Miles' personal guest.
That's so?
Yes, I've just been waiting your return. Now that you're back, you can take over.
Well, take over what?
Drew Holt is a thief, Marshal.
The new banker?
Now, I haven't told anybody yet.
You did?
Maybe he's changed.
He was a spy.
Holt?
On my word as an officer, sir, and a gentleman. We caught him, but he escaped. Man's no good, he's got to be stopped.
Well, it may be true that he spies for both sides, General, but, well, that doesn't necessarily make him a thief.
But he's no banker. He's just waiting for enough deposits to make it worthwhile. Man who spied for both sides, he lived through it. You're underestimating the enemy, Marshal. Well, I warned you, anything will happen will be on your head.
I mean, I definitely keep your eyes open if someone says that.
Dodge has grown in the couple of weeks you've been away, hasn't it? Too bad.
He missed a lot when he was away.
See, I don't know what he's got against me. I never. Already I've lost three depositors because of his crazy lies. I'm going to ask you to lock him up. There must be laws to protect businessmen from such scoundrels. Or not, Marshal. I was never in the army. I have a bad heart.
He's trying to...
Well, it doesn't matter.
See if he'll contradict what the old man was
there
saying.
There is one... Why'd you hire a gunman like Nash? You know he's a gunman.
Well, I have a lot of folks' money here. I mean to protect it.
How do you know you can trust him?
As long as I pay him, he'll be loyal.
I hope you're right.
Put it in there! Your money's as good as gone! Believe me!
Ooh.
What is that?
Take your hands off me, sir!
Kind of have to do something going. About that.
Nash. You want somebody your own weight, Nash?
You as any kind of a marshal, you'd have this old buzzard behind bars.
Marshal, what kind of men they are? I warned you.
He could be
you
insane.
Yes, I did. I mean to...
Marshal, aren't you going to lock those scoundrels up?
General, I've told you that you talk too much. Now I'm warning you. You let me handle it.
Wait for him to make a chink in the armor or something.
Very well, sir. If you don't want my support...
He'd probably seen as someone who's like old school and like not with it anymore.
What a talker.
For that time.
You should have heard...
They told me you rode in with a remount party, special guest of General Miles.
Remount party, nothing. He came with me all the way from Hayes City.
Well, he's a liar, maybe. But I'm not as sold on his hold as I might be.
Sure. You gotta give him a chance, though, don't you? Like,
well,
I don't...
hope you're right.
And the new bank's gonna mean a lot to the whole country around here.
I Just thought I'd take a look at your uniform. Your medals and all.
Oh, no, you see, I left everything at Fort Dodge, traveling.
Convenient. I like the way it's doing it there. It's making I really don't
your
know
talk is hurting the
what
town.
Way to go with this. We need this bank here. It's a really good episode. It's intriguing.
I was like decorated by
general. The general feels like the good guy, but a thief could just be a whole.
I mean it.
I have different
fire,
reasons
eh?
For wanting it.
Well, I never retreated under fire in my life.
Business.
You'll get your food soon enough, but it'll be too late then.
I'm not going to argue with you, General. I'm going to run you out of Dodge.
Better listen to me at Bull Run. There'd have been no disaster.
General.
He's being fair though, like, because this guy keeps persisting.
I'll do my duty as I
he has to move him out of the town.
Always have and always will.
Easy, man. That's. He wants to take him out. What's his name?
I live here, Marshal.
I've decided you better check out, Nash. Out of here and out of Dodge. Just because I don't like your kind around.
You can't do that.
Straightforward enough explanation. I mean, if you're being honest, you could say that the Marshal is wrong in a lot of things he's doing in this episode.
Smith, but you haven't told me anything about him yet. It's Drew Holt. Didn't he buy himself a house out at the edge of town?
Yeah.
Well, now. General Smith's at it again.
Out in front of the bank?
No, he moved down to the corner. He's scared of Nash, I guess. It's Drew Holt. The man's an out-and-out crook. He'll make off with every penny you give him. Doc Adams.
Hello, Parsley.
What are you doing in Dodge?
Oh, I live here. What are you doing here?
I was on my way to Arizona. I stopped here because, well, I guess you heard of Drew Holt and his bank. I already saved two men from losing their money this afternoon.
Well, that's all you're going to save. Till dark, General. If I see you around town after that, I'll have to lock you up.
The way it's going now, though, the fact saying that he has to go.
I mean it.
I think the General might be right. In some form or capacity. Why is that guy looking like that?
In Mexico with General Scott. Turned out he'd never been in
anybody's army. Doesn't mean he might be wrong, though.
And thanks for running that old fool off.
I ran off your man Nash, too, Mr. Holt. From now on, if your bank needs protection...
Ask for me.
I'll handle it.
Yeah, there's something brewing there.
You seen him, Mr. Dillon?
Not yet. Have you?
No.
You're wild.
Oh! Nash kill Holt, or not Holt, the general. The general just started gunfire himself.
It's Drew Holt's house. The general's gone plumb crazy.
General!
God. We're trying to use this as an opportunity to shoot at.
I got his gunman. That's Nash lying dead on the front porch.
Oh, shit.
I said, give it to me.
You gonna take over?
He's gonna arrest you.
Yeah, I'm... Holt! That's Dillon. Come on out of there.
Jeez. I mean... Oh, he got him. No one will ever know what the story was.
Holt. Holt, can you hear me?
You did it, Marshal. He winged me, but you did it. I should have killed him a long time ago.
So what was their history?
Dead?
Looks like it.
Yeah.
Oh, he's gonna rob all the money from the bank.
I don't suppose there's any use in my asking you how you really knew about Holt, is there?
So he did.
Gotta sit down.
He was right all along.
It's been a long night. Him being a spy.
I thought you'd more likely believe that than what really happened. Things I made up seem better than the way things actually happened.
A few weeks back, you know the Grand Hotel there?
I had a room next to this Drew Holt fella. And I used to sit in the dark. They was plotting right outside on the balcony. I fooled them good, I sure did.
So what about banks, money they would steal?
You know, Marshal.
Did he get shot as well?
Oh, my goodness. Looks like he's killing. He's been shot.
I wonder if the adrenaline, he didn't even realize he got shot.
He's dead, Chester. He even lied about being hit.
He didn't lie about Drew Holt, though.
No. It's true all along.
He knew about Holt, but we'll never know how.
Well, he just told us how he overheard him and all.
Might have been lying about that as well. Just
a few Grand Hotel in Abilene burned down 2 years ago.
I wonder why when they knew, why he would need to lie about that. Something else to hide. So that was Gunsmoke, Season 1, Episode 11, General Parcley Smith. This again is me, just Gunsmoke at its best. When it's character-driven, you know, narratives that make you think. I just think that's when it's at its... that it's at its absolute best is when it does these kind of stories. And the fact that I was like just kept second guessing myself, trying to decide, is Holt really just a guy just trying to set up a business, or is the general actually telling the truth? Is he not just some crazy guy? And I just kept flip-flopping between the two, trying to decide who to trust. And then when I got to that point where I was thinking, you know, they're angling it like the general is a good guy and Holt is the bad guy, maybe it's going to turn out that no, Holt actually isn't this bad guy, you know. And I actually had come to the point where I was like, no, he actually seems to be just an innocent guy. And in the final twist at the end, where I realized, no, they actually were trying to steal the money, it was really well executed the way they unraveled the story. So yeah, very, very good episode. I really enjoyed it. But until next time, guys, it's long before.